Hi friends, welcome back in our channel Colourful Aviation. We all know aircrafts have changed enormously over the last century. From the early Wright flyer flown at Kitty Hawk to the supersonic SR-71 Blackbird flown today. In this video, we will know about the brief history of aircraft structure. So friends, let's start to topic. History of aircraft structure start from a simple wood truss structure to the sleek aerodynamic flying machine of today. Airfoil shape is a key of an aircraft structure. George Kelly developed an efficient camber airfoil in early 80s, as well as successful man glider later in that century. Kelly was the first person who created a stuck wings, tri wings glider that flew and manned in 1853. Kelly studied the center of a gravity of flying machines, effect of wing dihedral, direction control of a wings by including the earliest form of rudder on his glider. Otto Lilienthal built upon Kelly's discoveries. He manufactured and flew his own glider on over the 2000 flights. His willow and cloth aircraft had wings designed from extensive study of bird wings. Lilienthal also made standard use of vertical and horizontal fins behind the wings. All of these he proved that man could fly. Octogenut, a retired railroad and bridge engineer, was active in aviation during the 1890s. He built gliders similar to Lilienthal's and then his own. In addition to his publication, Chanute advanced aircraft structure development by building a glider with the stuck wings, incorporating the use of wires as wing support. All of work of these men was known to the Wright brother when they built their successful power aeroplane in 1903. Wright flyer had biplane thin cloth cover wing attached to the truss structure made of wood. In 1909, Frenchman Louis Blériot built a successful mono-wing aircraft. The wings were still supported by wires, but the mast extending above the fuselage enabled the wing to be supported from above as well as underneath. Blériot used a Pratt truss type fuselage frame. In 1910, German Hugo Junker was able to build an aircraft with metal truss construction and metal skin instead of a wood to eliminate the need for the external wing braces and wires. His J-1 also had a single set of wings instead of stuck wings. During World War I, need for a large quantity of reliable aircraft, designers developed the stronger engines, thicker wings with the stronger spar without wire wing bracing, and higher camber wing created for a more lift. In wartime, aircraft mostly used for the reconnaissance. In 1920s, the use of metal in aircraft construction increased. Fuselages able to carry cargo and passengers were developed. Early flying boats with their hull-type construction from the shipbuilding industry provide the blueprint for the semi-monocoque construction of fuselages. In 1930s, all-metal aircraft accompanied new lighter and more powerful engines. Larger semi-coque fuselages were complemented with the stress skin wing design. In World War II, brought about the myriad of aircraft designs using all-metal technology. Deep fuel carrying wings were the norm, but desire for higher flight speed promoted the development of a thin wings aircraft in which fuel was carried in the fuselage. De Havilland Mosquito developed first composite structure aircraft. Use a balsa wood sandwich material in the construction of a fuselage. The fiberglass radome was also developed during this period. During World War II, Sir Frank Whittle and Hans von Ohain developed the invention of a turbine engine. Turbine engine lead to higher altitude flight. For the higher altitude flight, semi-monocoque construction needed to made more stronger because of pressurization and depressurization cycles. also developed the round window and doors to avoid the weak areas where cracks could form. Chemical milling of a wing skin structure provides a great strength and smooth high-performance surface. Multi-spar and box-wing wing design as a developed in a response of a increasing wing loading. In 1960s, larger aircraft were developed to carry passengers and engines technology also improved. Because of larger size of aircraft required the lighter and stronger material to build the aircraft. Hence, the use of honeycomb structure in aircraft for save weight but not compromising the strength. Initially, aluminium core with the aluminium or fiberglass skin sandwich panel were used on wing panel, flight control surfaces, cabin floor boards and other applications. A steady increase in the use of honeycomb or foam core sandwich components, wide variety of a composite material present in 1970. For this advanced technique and material combination, structure of aircraft shift from aluminium to the carbon fiber and other strong lightweight materials. Many airframe structures are made of more than 50% advanced composite, with some airframes approaching 100%. Very light jet has a new generation of a jet aircraft made almost entirely of a advanced composite material. Apart from the carbon fiber and other composite, researchers have been looking into the completely redefining the shape of aircraft. Researchers at MIT has been developing the blended wing concept, and NASA are exploring the technology of morphing or shape changing and taking the inspiration directly from nature. In upcoming years, aviation will develop more reliable structure of aircraft and will present more advanced aircraft. It is all about developing in a structure of aircraft in aviation. If you like my video, like it, share it and subscribe my channel. Bye friends, stay safe and healthy.